Welcome to IGM Guru. IGM Guru is one of the global leading online training and certification provider for IT expert by the skilled IT gurus to help them achieve their professional goals.
Hello everyone. Today I'm going to take a session on Amazon Web Services. So it is a most demanding technology right now in the market. So quick introduction about myself. My name is Sai. Right now, I'm working as a senior cloud architect in my organization. I have around 6+ years of IT experience. So you can see the certifications which I'm holding right now. All these three, AWS Certified Solutions Architect, Certified Developer, as well as Certified SysOps Administrator. So this is all about myself. So believe me, I have very good hands-on experience. And as well as I know the course content and the examination syllabus and each and everything. Okay, I will cover all the topics which are required for the all three certification examinations. Okay. So now you can see on the screen, this is 15 top paying IT certifications in 2018. So this list is given by Forbes. Forbes already, I think you might know that this is a famous research, it publishes article every year, all top four positions. For example, top 10 richest persons, top 10 famous companies, top 15 companies like that. So this year it published, not only this year, every year it publishes all top positions. So top 15 paying IT certifications in 2018. So you can see the second one is AWS Certified Solution Architect and the fourth one is AWS Certified Developer. So out of in first four, two certifications are occupied by AWS certifications. So now by this you can understand the demand. Okay, the every company is, every recruiter is looking for the certified people. So these are very much in demand and they will be paid more. Okay, that's why I would suggest you to go for these certifications. These are very, very important. As well as, these are not so difficult and not so easy. Okay, so you need to do hard work to get these certifications. And believe me, I will clear all your doubts and I will cover all the course content. Okay, which they ask in the certifications. Okay, next you can see these certifications, all three certifications which I'm holding. These are the certifications. The first one is a Solutions Architect, second one is Developer, and third one is SysOps Administrator. So this certification is, valid for only for 2 years. After completion of 2 years, you need to get renewed after every 2 years, because AWS keeps changing its content and each and everything. Even dashboard and all options, it keeps changing. So that's why keeping old content is of useless. Now you can see this is the Gartner Magic Quadrant. What is this? This is the world's leading information technology research and advisory company. Okay, so it has given this quadrant. You can see it is divided into four cubes. The first one is niche players, second one is visionaries, third one is challengers, and fourth one is leaders. So you can see in leaders, Amazon Web Services, these each occupied the top position. Okay, next followed by Microsoft. Okay, even though Microsoft Azure, it occupied a second position. Azure means the cloud, the name of cloud which is provided by Microsoft is Azure. Okay, so you can see the difference between Amazon Web Services and Microsoft Azure. There is a huge gap between these two. Okay, even though Microsoft occupied second position. Next, if you look at this Google is still at visionaries level only, not even leaders. Okay, so blindly you can go for AWS because AWS, it started its career in 2004. Microsoft Azure, it started its career in 2010. Okay, so you can come to a conclusion that for next 6 to 7 years, Amazon will be in a first position. It will be top position, that is for sure. Okay, next. Okay, so before explaining the cloud computing, first we should understand what usually happened before cloud. So what was the traditional method that we used to follow? So before cloud computing, suppose if I want to launch a web, if I want to host a web application, so what are the prerequisites? What are the minimum requirements should I have? So first I need to buy physical servers. Okay, physical servers, they are very costly. And also I need to have required configuration like RAM, hard disk, okay, each and everything. So those are not cheap, they are pretty costly. And so once I purchase those servers, I need to install the operating systems. I need to do patch updates frequently. Okay, these are the requirements. So these are very costly. And second point is keeping the peak traffic in mind by more servers. I'll give you one example. Suppose, imagine December 24th, 25th and 26th. So December 24th is a normal day. December 25th is Christmas day. 26th also normal day. Suppose, and 24th, I have four servers. I am launching a one Christmas sale. I need to, you know, launch a one product. So on 24th, the demand will be less. I mean, the web traffic will be very, very less. Okay, suppose I have only five servers on 24th. Okay, on 25th, the demand will be more because of that Christmas celebration. Suppose I need to have 10 servers. So with immediate effect, how can I purchase those servers? And also after purchasing those servers, I need to have all the setup ready. I need to have application, OS and all the things. Okay. By any means, I am ready with somehow I managed with another five servers. Okay, December 26th is a normal day, so I don't need those extra five servers because the traffic will be less, obviously. So there's a waste of resources. You know, the flexibility is not there here. Okay, I hope you understand this point. So keeping the peak traffic in mind, buy more servers. I need to buy more servers. That's also not so easy. Within one day, you know, I cannot make all the servers ready. Okay. Next, third point is monitoring and maintenance of your servers. So you need to monitor these servers 24/7. You need to make sure that CPU percentage should not cross more than 100%. What if it crosses 100%? So obviously you will be losing your server. Okay. And also maintenance of your servers. Maintenance part means you need to have proper setup, proper room, and you need to make sure that air conditioner is running fine. And you need to have system administrators, you need to have database administrators, network administrators, IT guys, okay, security. So all these aspects you should keep in your mind. Okay, so it is a very, you need to pay salaries for them, each and everything. You need to spend a lot of money for them. So maintenance part is very, very difficult. So this monitoring and maintenance of your server, it is very, very headache. So you can see the image which I have pasted here. The person is having headache because of all these issues. Okay, next, the setup is very expensive. The complete this setup is very expensive. Each and every stage you need to spend a lot of money. Okay, next, troubleshooting problems can be tedious and may conflict with your business goals. Okay, so suppose what happens, suppose if generally what the client give us deadlines. Okay, within that deadline we need to deliver our product. Suppose tomorrow I will be delivering my product. What happens today suddenly if a server crashes? Okay, it may crash, we cannot say, right? So what happens? So obviously client will be angry and result which we'll be losing our clients and projects. Okay, so these troubleshooting problems, okay, we can troubleshoot, but we don't have much time to troubleshoot. Okay, that is why it is tedious and may conflict with your business goals, because ultimately you'll be not reaching your goal. Okay, next. Since the traffic is varying, your servers will be idle most of the time. I already explained you, right? On the day of 25th, I need 10 servers. But on the day of December 26th, I need only 5 servers. I don't need other 5 servers. So remaining 5 servers will be sitting idle. So obviously, it's a waste of resources and wastage of money. Okay. These are the problems we used to get when we before cloud computing. Okay. So to address these issues, cloud computing emerged. So let's understand what is cloud computing. So it is not like you can see on the image which I have pasted on the right corner top side. Just someone is putting his RJ45 cable into the cloud. Okay, that's not cloud computing. So you can see on the screen the definition which is given in Amazon site is a official definition. Cloud computing is on-demand delivery of IT resources. Here the keyword is on-demand. Suppose right now I want 10 servers right now. Within 2 minutes, I want 10 servers. That is absolutely possible if we go for cloud computing. This is not at all possible if you want to purchase physical servers. Okay. So on-demand delivery of IT resources. Not only servers. IT resources means compute, storage, application. So many services which are being provided by AWS. Okay. So any type of service which is providing by AWS, you can get those servers. You can get those services on demand. Okay, whenever you want, you will get those servers. Okay, next, through a cloud service platform via internet. So how can you access those services via web, via internet? That means the positive thing is here, you can access those services anywhere in the world. Okay, today you are in India, tomorrow you might be in USA. Okay, but you can access those services very easily, because what you need to do, just Amazon provide one interface, web interface, you need to enter your credentials and you can access those services. Next, the final keyword is pay as you go pricing. Pay the capacity you use, not more than that. Okay, suppose today if you use your servers only for 2 hours, okay, after that once you shut down or you stop the servers, you have to pay only for those two hours. Okay, you need not to pay for entire day, unlike physical servers. Okay, if you buy physical server, whether you use it or not, you have to maintain those servers. Okay, obviously you have to pay more, you need to maintain all the security and maintenance part, but here you are paying only for the 2 hours. Okay, earlier Amazon used to charge for hourly basis, but nowadays it changed its policy. So Amazon is charging every 1 minute. That means if you use only for 30 minutes, you need not to pay for the whole hour. You have to pay only for that 30 minutes only. So obviously it's a saving of money. Next, the second definition, I have just compressed that definition so that it would be easier for us to remember. Simply accessing IT resources provided by cloud provider through web. Just we are accessing IT resources via web. That's it. Okay. Very, very easy definition. Next, whenever you hear this cloud computing word, you must remember these three keywords. Okay, the first one is on demand. On demand means whenever I need servers, IT resources, immediately I should get within fraction of minutes. That is on demand. Right now I want 10 servers, immediately I should get 10 servers. Okay, that is on demand. It is possible only if you go with the cloud. Next, scalable. Scalable means here both scale up and scale down. December 25th, I need to scale up to 10 servers. But December 26th, I need to scale down up to only 5 servers. The remaining 5 servers which are not required for me. So it is possible if you go for cloud computing. So we have one famous service that is called auto scaling. I'll explain you once we start our actual course. Okay. So Amazon is very famous for its auto scaling. This scalable, scale up and scale down as per our requirements. Next, pay only for the capacity you use. Already explained you. So whatever the capacity that you use, you pay only for that one, not more than that. Okay. Next, what are the advantages of cloud? So scalability as per traffic. Okay, as per traffic. So I already explained you. 25th, I need 10 servers. 26th, I need only 5 servers. Okay. On 25th, immediately I need to scale up to 10 servers. Okay, so that is a scalability as per traffic. If traffic increases, I need to scale up my servers. Okay, that is the thing. Next, zero maintenance headaches. So I already explained you, right? We don't need to maintain, we don't need to have proper room setup and security, administrators, all kinds of administrators, whether it could be system administrators, database administrators, network administrators, IT guys. Okay, we don't need anyone. Okay, zero maintenance. Everything will be taken care by Amazon. Okay, all kinds of securities, patch updates, each and everything. Okay, your application will never be down. The kind of assurance Amazon is providing for us. Okay, generally it provides SLA, that is service level agreement. Okay, it states that your application will never be down. Your server will never be down. Okay, the kind of assurance Amazon is providing for us. So we don't need to take any headaches. Okay, simply blindly we can believe AWS. Why we should believe AWS? Even the US government also planning to outsource its defense and all IT resources to this AWS. So US government is believing AWS, means at least we can believe. Okay, not only US government, all governments, almost major governments planning to outsource their resources into AWS. So the kind of assurance and security AWS is providing for us. Next, access from any place. You can access from any place, because anywhere you will get internet all over the world, right? So anywhere, if you today you are in India, tomorrow you might be in Europe, so you can access from there as well. Simply you log in and you will access all the IT resources. Okay, next, on-demand provisioning. So this is also I explained you. Suppose right now I need 100 servers, immediately I will get 100 servers with my required configuration. Okay, so this is a very, very, you know, useful thing, right? Next, reduce data disaster. I'll give you one example. Suppose if I keep my photo in AWS, what Amazon does is Amazon replicate that, it saves that photo in 2 to 3 locations. So that unfortunately, if I lose one object, I can recover that object from other location. That means no data disaster. Okay, so our object will never be lose. Okay, you know the kind of security, I mean Amazon is giving, the kind of assurance, 99.999 up to 9 nines. I mean total 11 nines. 11 nines kind of security Amazon is providing for us. Okay, almost 100% assurance, 100% security. Your data will never be lose. Okay, next, pay as you go. Whatever the capacity you use, that much only you need to pay, not more than that. Save your time. So obviously, if I need 10 servers right now, immediately I'll be getting all those 10 servers. So suppose if I go for physical servers, so as per my knowledge, minimum it should take not less than 15 days, because you need to purchase those servers, you need to, you know, you need to have OS and you need to install softwares, all applications, and you need to get ready with all setup and maintenance and security, all those things. Minimum it should take a minimum 15 days. Okay, so that time you will be saving here. Okay, right now within minutes you will be launching your servers. Next, generate more money. Obviously time is money. If you are saving your time, means you are generating more money. I hope till now it is clear. Next. Okay, so as of now it is clear AWS cloud is good, but why we should go for AWS? We have other cloud providers also. Microsoft cloud provider, the name is Azure. Okay, next, IBM Cloud, Google Cloud Platform, Alibaba Cloud. Okay, so there are so many cloud providers, but you can see the market percentage Amazon is holding almost 1/3 out of 100. 1/3 it is the Amazon holding the share. Remaining 2/3 is taken by all other cloud providers. Okay, so Amazon has the highest share in the market. So we can conclude that it has more well matured, you know, establishment in terms of physical infrastructure and in terms of the policies, in terms of pricing, everything. So we can go for Amazon blindly. Okay, we can blindly believe Amazon. Okay, next, I'll elaborate a little bit clearly. Whatever I explained you in previous slide, that is also same. You can see here almost AWS global cloud computing market share is almost 1/3. Okay, about 30%. Next, the second image you can see, that is in yellow color. What it says is the server capacity, that means the physical infrastructure Amazon is having. Suppose remaining all cloud providers, if they are having, suppose, just imagine, if they are having 100 servers, just Amazon itself is having 600 servers. That means 6 into all remaining cloud providers. So this much of physical capacity, physical servers Amazon is holding. So what is the use? What is the use for us? So for example, tomorrow, if I would like to launch 100 servers, okay, because of, you know, I already explained you, Christmas sale, I would like to launch 100 servers immediately. We can blindly go for AWS. We cannot believe other cloud providers, because we don't know whether they are having physical infrastructure ready or not. But Amazon is having physical infrastructure ready, right place. Okay, so this is what server capacity. Next, flexible pricing. I already explained you, Amazon now charging for every 1 minute. Okay, if you are using only for half an hour, you need to pay only for that half an hour, not for the remaining time. Okay, so, and compared to other cloud providers, as per my knowledge, the charges are also very less. Okay, Amazon charges very less. Next, this is a global AWS platform. So AWS global infrastructure, you can see the bottom line. That means the physical infrastructure which is present in all over the world. Okay, Amazon is maintaining its infrastructure all over the world, not in a single place. Because what happens if tomorrow that single place affected by some natural calamities? Okay, that's why it's a global infrastructure present everywhere in the world. Okay, even if we lose one place, all other places will provide backup. Okay, So Amazon is providing so many services. Okay, that's why it is called Amazon Web Services. Okay, Amazon is providing so many services. So like a compute, storage, database, migration, network and content delivery, developer tools, machine learning, media services, management tools, okay, and so many other things. Even nowadays it started, you know, serverless, that is Lambda, and Internet of Things, okay, game development, artificial intelligence, okay, all these services Amazon is providing for us. Okay, so I will explain you each and every service which is pretty important for the examination. So in this course I will be covering the all three certifications, okay, all three certifications with all each and every topic which is very much required for the course and also for the interview purpose. Okay, believe me guys, Amazon keeps on updating its syllabus because every now and then it changes its syllabus. So I also update my syllabus so that you know you can, it would be easier for you to crack your certification in a first go. Okay, so you need to renew your certification every 2 years. Okay, anyways, I will explain you clearly about the certification process and everything, and also the interview questions, because I have taken hundreds of interviews. Okay, I know what actually recruiters look from a AWS guy. I mean, what are the services he should know to get selected. Okay, so each and everything I will explain you. Okay, now I will continue this this discussion by, you know, the course content. I will show the course content. So first one is, you know, AWS Certified Solutions Architect syllabus. I will clearly explain what are the topics which Amazon is mentioned in its course content. Okay, first one, anyways, I will explain you the course content overview and exam blueprint. Okay, next, identity access management. This is one kind of service Amazon is providing. Okay, it is kind of, you know, creating users and creating groups and administering them and setting up of some policies, giving limited access, because I have an account, I have root access, I cannot give my root account credentials to every user. Okay, so that's why I give limited privileges. So this is a service I will explain you clearly. Okay, I will do deep dive into all these services. Next services are CDN, S3, that is S3 bucket, Glacier and Tolerant. These are, you know, storage services. In this we will be covering CDN, that is Content Delivery Network, Glacier and Tolerant. Next, these are the topics, these are the various topics inside this major service. So we will be covering all these services. Okay, all these are pretty important. Snowball, Storage Gateway, Transfer Acceleration. We can create a static website by using S3. This is also kind of serverless. We don't need to have server. Okay, without server we can launch a website. Okay, at the end of every service, initially I will start with the theory part, and after that I will give you clear practical thing how to work with it. After completion of that practical thing, I will give you summary. Summary consists of examination questions as well as interview questions. Next, EC2. This is a backbone of AWS. This is a pretty famous service. It is a kind of, you know, cornerstone of AWS. Okay, in EC2 we have so many options, so many things we need to cover. All these are pretty famous. Okay, I'll cover each and everything. Next, Route 53. It is a DNS service which is providing by AWS. Okay, in this we have so many options like simple routing policy, weighted routing policy, and so many other policies are there. We'll explain each and everything one by one. Okay. Next, databases on AWS. We have SQL databases, NoSQL, like DynamoDB. And Aurora, which is especially given by AWS, okay, and multiple backups, multi AZs, read replicas, everything we'll be covering. Okay. Next to VPC means virtual private cloud. It's a kind of, you know, network thing. It comes under the network section. Okay, in this I will explain you about IP addresses and creating our own virtual private cloud, and all these things we will explain. VPC, believe me guys, very very important for examination. You will get this in all three certifications. Okay, it covers a major part of examination, all three certifications. Next, some of the application services like simple queue service, simple notification service. SNS means it's a kind of SMS service, just sending a notification. Elastic transcoder, application services summary. Next, I'll cover white papers. Okay, these are all 5 white papers. Okay, they are pretty important. Even we get some of the questions from white papers as well. So my aim is that you should not miss even single question. So that's why I'll be covering all the topics. Okay. Next, these are, you can see these are certified developer syllabus. So for certified developer syllabus, actually, you know, there is no prerequisite to do this certified solutions architect or developer or sysop administrator. Straight away you can write any exam. But my suggestion is first you go with the solutions architect, then developer, then sysops. Because there is some prerequisites in terms of, you know, syllabus. Till now, whatever I have explained you, the course contained everything. In developer exam, certified solutions architect course content plus you need to learn some extra concepts. Those extra concepts are DynamoDB. So we'll do deep dive in DynamoDB and two major concepts. These are cloud formation and elastic beanstalk. They are very, very, very important for developer. Okay. So what here we are doing, first we'll cover the course content for topics for AWS certified solutions architect. After that, we'll cover developer course. So that, you know, it would be easier for me. If you want to do developer exam, you need to learn all the topics which they ask in solutions architect. Okay. So that's why I prepared this in a sequential manner so that it would be easier for you. Next, for sysop administrator, solutions architect syllabus is mandatory and also developer syllabus also mandatory. Apart from that, you need to learn remaining things. Okay, like monitoring, that is a cloud watch. We'll do deep dive into cloud watch. Okay, what it is and monitoring of each and every service. Okay. Next, ops work, it comes under, you know, DevOps. You might have heard some of the tools like Chef, Ansible, DevOps tools. Okay, like that Amazon is providing its own service, that is ops work. So this is the syllabus. Okay. With this, we completed the course content for the all certifications. I'll explain each and every topic in a very, very detailed manner. Okay. I'll not lose even a single topic. Okay. Each and everything I will cover. Okay. Once you are ready with all this content syllabus, you will be, you know, good position to write all three certifications and you will track your interview. Okay. So this is all about this AWS demo. And I hope it is clear. I hope it is useful. Okay. Once you are good with this, immediately we'll start our course. Okay. Thank you so much.
Thanks for watching the video. For full course, please visit www.igmguru.com and enroll today.